Self-arrest, or ice axe breaking, is a very important skill that could save your life in the event of a slip. It should, however, be viewed as a technique of last resort, because it would be much better to avoid slipping in the first place by using sound footwork and solid use of the ice axe. Putting crampons on if they're needed is very important. If you do slip, it may be possible to stop the slip from becoming a fall just by using the ice axe straight away. So here, although my feet slipped off, I was able to slide my hand down the shaft of my ice axe and stop the fall immediately. In order to be prepared for a full-blown slip, it's obviously necessary to have your ice axe in the uphill hand and with the pick facing to the rear. And when I slip, I'm bringing my ice axe round across my body. I've got the shaft of the ice axe diagonally across my body, the pick pointing out, and my lower hand close down to the spike of the ice axe to stop it from sticking into me. I've got my elbows tucked into the side, so I've got a really firm grip. When I'm on the ground, I've got my head over the ice axe pick to get as much weight as possible, but I turn my face away so that it doesn't get damaged unnecessarily by any snow coming up. I've got my feet in the air, very important, so that if I'm wearing crampons, I don't cartwheel down the slope. I've got my knees wide apart to give me stability so I don't roll from side to side. And I'm arching my back so that my stomach is not lying on the snow and my weight is supported between my knees and the pick of the ice axe. If you do slip, it's going to be totally unexpected, so you won't know what position your body is in. There's about 7 or 8 different ways that you might be sliding down the slope that it would be useful to practice. We're going to look at 4 of them. So the first one you might describe as the basic position. This is where you're on your front with your head uppermost. So I've got my feet well clear of the snow, heels lifted up, knees apart to provide stability, and I've got my head over the pick of the axe and my face turned away. I'm arching my back so I get maximum weight onto the pick. The second position, you're on your back with your head uppermost, and you've got to get round onto your front to the basic position. So you roll over towards whichever hand is holding the head of the axe, and while you're doing that, lift your feet clear to keep them out of the snow in case you're wearing crampons. We then go into the basic position. The third technique is if you're sliding down the slope head first on your front. First thing we need to do is to get the right way up. To do this, we put the ice axe out to one side with as straight an arm as possible. Apply some pressure with the pick, gently if it's a very hard pack, snow or ice, and then your feet will come round below you. You'll be in the right position. We then have to take the axe out, raise up the shoulders, and place the axe under your shoulder and get into the basic position. As your body swings round the right way up, very important to lift your heels clear of the snow so that if you're wearing crampons, your front points won't catch. The fourth technique is the one to use if you're going head first down the slope on your back. So now we have to get round the right way and over onto our fronts all in one movement. So to do this, we get the pick in comfortably about hip level. Try and sit up, put your knees and feet together, and spin round at the same time as getting yourself over onto your front. And remember to keep your heels and your feet clear of the snow. If you end up in the final position, just carry on. If you find that your arms are stretched above you, hanging onto the ice axe, you must take it out, lift up your shoulders, and get the axe firmly in and into the final position.
Practice these techniques, but always with someone else. It's safer, and they can provide vital feedback on your technique. Before starting any practice session, make an avalanche assessment of the slope. Choose a location where you'll come to a stop naturally, even if you don't self-arrest effectively. Think about the runout. You don't want to be sliding into rocks or a stream. Never wear crampons when practicing, as this could easily lead to an injury. Never attach your axe to yourself when practicing. If you lose grip, it could injure you. And finally, wear a well-fitted helmet to protect your head.